is one question that I have been also asked many times. So I'm asking you this, which state management is best to use?
Okay, state management. Okay, I'll tell you what's my favorite at the end, but all are good. Trust me, when I started learning Flutter, what I did was I took a simple counter app, which is that plus and minus. When you, the moment you create a Flutter project, you get the counter app, right? So I created the same app using all the state management. That is provider, block, simple set state, everything I started creating. So I got to know that when to use what. So it totally depends on your project complexity, your project scenario, your requirement, what's the client requirement, what is the future goal of this project. Based on that, you have to decide. So there's nothing wrong, nothing right. If it is a simple counter app, why would I use block? The code of the block itself is more than the functional logic of the counter app, right? So that's where your logical thinking comes. So you decide what is the best. There's nothing wrong in using a provider or even using a river pod. It totally depends on your project scenario and use it. And justify yourself as to why you're using it. Because at the end of the day, you're the one going to do it, right? So if someone finds block is good, that means the project is quite suitable for that. So go ahead with that. So if you ask me what's my best, I would go with provider. That's, I have been using it. It's pretty simple, straightforward for most of the project that I'm using. And I've used it, I'm pretty comfortable with. But second best is my block. Because when I go to complex app, I'll have to use block. Or else I simply stick to set state. That's more than enough to do the logic of the app.
Okay, so means according to the app we are building, we should choose that.
Definitely. That's where the logical thinking comes, because you're not just doing a project, right? You're building something for someone. So you need to think about it.
So if you find this video helpful, then make sure to share it with all your tech friends. And do hit that like button. It really motivates me to make much more quality content for you. And if you have any doubts, suggestions or feedback, then make sure to put it in the comments below. And if you haven't subscribed till now, then make sure to hit the subscribe button, because I'm going to come up with amazing content on this channel. So now I will see you in the next episode. Till then, keep learning, keep growing. Thank you.